Free weights, they work in one plane, the vertical plane. You're resisting gravity, that's it. Now with bands, if I were to connect this to something, wherever I anchor it, I've got resistance in multiple directions. So that means that I could do things even in a horizontal plane.
I remember seeing a video in 2009 of you actually in the Olympia floor with just a bag of bands, and you're walking up to all these athletes that you almost were challenging them to do it. And everybody looked at you the same way I'm gonna look at you now, with complete skepticism about this, because you know, you're telling me I'm going to do a complete muscle building transformation with resistance bands. When you told me that, I mean, look, I'm always up for all of your antics and fun, but you know, I thought you had an actual program that you were gonna run, an actual muscle building program, and you were going to supplement them with the resistance bands, and you're like, no, I'm just doing a complete...
Total substitute.
Just give us a little breakdown on how that's gonna work.
So I've always had, I've always liked bands. Like you said, even in 2009, I was doing videos for Muscle and Fitness Magazine talking about bands. And it's always bothered me that there's this misconception about how effective bands are for building muscle. I think most people have it in their head that bands are for old people trying to rehabilitate, or, you know, if you're gonna go on vacation, you can throw some bands in your suitcase.
They're not wrong.
No, they're not wrong. But that's not the limitation of bands. So that's what I wanted to talk about today. But even going back to 2009, when I walked around the Olympia, you're talking about that video, I took guys that, you know, professional bodybuilders, guys that are obviously very strong, and yeah, challenge them to do some of these different exercises, traditional movements like a shoulder press, but instead of using weights, using bands. And you know, pretty funny to watch a big guy struggle using bands, because people think the bands are easy. And that's the biggest misconception, is that you really can't build muscle with bands because they're too easy.
You can tell they were a little bit embarrassed almost at a certain point, like, because they're not, because it was harder or whatever, because they're, you know, athletes, but because they underestimated it, and by the look on their face and then by the time they got it up, they're like, whoa.
Yeah, when they start shaking.
When
they're doing a shoulder press and their arms and shoulders start shaking. I mean, look, don't get me wrong, I love free weights. So this video is not about saying that bands are better than free weights. No, I love free weights. I even love some machines, although I don't use a lot of machines. I like resistance training, and bands are just another way to do resistance training. And we talk about, you know, summiting a mountain. There's not just one path to the summit of the mountain. So there's not just one way to build muscle. There's multiple ways to build muscle. And that's the cool thing about fitness. You don't just have to get locked into one way of doing things. But that's a problem. People get locked into this one way. It's like, no, this is the only way. You know, you have to do it this way, or you have to do compound movements, or you have to, and that's what I used to talk about before. Like, no, you don't have to come in and do crazy deadlifts if you want to build mass. Is it a great tool? Yeah, it's a great tool, but it's not the only way. So same thing with bands. You know, they're just another way to do it.
Well, let's start it off. What is, to you, like, let's say, what are three differences between free weights and bands?
Well, before we talk about the differences, why don't we talk about the similarities between them? So I actually have some stuff mapped out on the board here. So bands versus free weights. So what do they offer that's the same? Well, the first thing is going to be progressive resistance. We talk about progressive overload, right? If you want to build muscle, that's one of the most important things, is as you get stronger, you have to continually challenge the muscle to force a muscle to adapt. So progressive resistance. So with free weights, what does that mean? That means you can just pick up heavier and heavier dumbbells. And as you get stronger, you can lift heavier weight. Well, you can do the exact same thing with bands. I know people think that they're limited, but they're not. Not only are there different resistance in bands, but you can also stack bands together. You can create unlimited resistance, and I'll show that in a minute. Variable speed. So both free weights and bands. What's that mean? Well, that means that, you know, we can control our negatives, get a nice slow negative. We can control our rep speed, which means time under tension, right? So that's time under tension per rep and total time under tension per set. Key variable in building muscle. So you got the exact same thing between the two. The last one, free range of motion, or free range of movement. So Unlike machines, where a lot of times you're locked into a fixed plane or a fixed movement, free weights, you've got a little more flexibility. If we're doing, say, a dumbbell press, I can press them straight up or I can squeeze them to the middle. We've got free range of movement. You got the exact same thing on bands. So now here's where they're different. Even on the things that they're the same, I would say that there's some advantages to bands within these two things right here, which is speed, and it's also going to be movement. And so we'll talk about that here and the things that are different, the advantages that bands actually have over free weights. So the first one is going to be variable resistance, which is different than progressive resistance. This one just means we can continually go heavier as we get stronger. Variable resistance means that as we're doing, say, a curl, let me grab a band here. So as we're doing a curl, through that range of motion, as we get closer to the top, the more this band stretches, the harder it is to pull. So it's not fixed resistance. Now, with a dumbbell, it weighs the same no matter what. All the way through the range of motion, it weighs exactly the same. Whereas, like I said, with the bands, the more you stretch it, the harder it gets. So variable resistance. A muscle is strongest about the midway point of the contraction. So at the bottom, it's going to be the weakest. So right here, I'm at my weakest point. I'm limited on how much weight I can use based on the beginning of the range of the movement. Now, knowing that we've got variable resistance here, that means I can pick a band that at the bottom of the range of motion, I'm challenging the muscle, but as I reach a stronger point and as that band stretches, it's giving me more resistance. So bands follow your natural strength curve more closely. So that's a real advantage that you have with bands over free weights. Now, resistance in multiple directions. Free weights, they work in one plane, the vertical plane. You're resisting gravity, that's it. So unless you're in a position where the weight is resisting gravity, you have no resistance. So if I want to work chest, that means I have to lie on a bench and I have to do bench press, or I have to do a dumbbell press and press that dumbbell against gravity. Now with bands, if I were to connect this to something, wherever I anchor it, I've got resistance in multiple directions. So that means that I can do things even in a horizontal plane. Constant tension through the range of motion. Let's go back to our dumbbell. This is true with a lot of exercises. So again, we're fighting gravity. As I reach this point right here, I've got gravity working fully against me. But as I get to the top of the range of motion, I really don't have a lot of resistance here. I could probably sit here all day just resting the weight in this position. So that means at the peak contraction of the muscle, I don't have a lot of resistance. Whereas with bands, I've got that constant tension all the way through, even to the very peak. So that means I can get a peak contraction. So constant tension through range of motion. Now this one's a big one. Prevents using momentum, in other words, cheating. So we talked about the fact that we're at our weakest point down here at the bottom, we're at our strongest here. So what do people have a tendency to do? Well, they'll go heavier to challenge themselves at their strongest position, but that means in order to get that in motion, they cheat it, they swing it. You can't swing or use momentum with bands. There's no such thing. And that's the real advantage that we're talking about here with variable speed. You have more options with bands than you do with free weights, because you can do explosive movements with bands, because no matter how fast you do the movement, you're never gonna have momentum working in your favor. So let's say that we're doing those presses again. I can go ahead and I can do explosive movements. Now you're talking about fast twitch muscle fibers. Same type of muscle fibers that make you jump higher or run faster are also the ones that are more apt to get bigger, to build muscle size, build muscle strength. Also, if we're talking about sports, functional strength. So it gives us more options in the way we train. Now, the way I've been training, I'll do slower rep speeds like I would with free weights, and then I'll finish with a couple sets with explosive movements. And you want to talk about getting a burn and a pump, it's crazy, and you can't do that with free weights. So that's another advantage that you have with bands over free weights. Then the last two are kind of obvious ones. Bands are cheap. you can go on Amazon, wherever you want to go, and you can pick up, like right here, I've got everything, and it all fits in a little bag that I've got. I've got a whole gym's worth of exercises that fits in a little tiny bag. I picked them all up on Amazon, super cheap. And number two, it's portable. I'm taking every exercise that I could do in a gym, and I've got it right here.
Now, a question I have for you, and maybe a couple other people, but how true are those bands to the actual weight? So let's say you have a 60-pound resistance band.
There, I mean, you can't look at it that way. You can't look at what the actual weight is. In other words, if I were to, you know, pick up this green one.
You have to understand how traditional people work, though. Weights going up, weights, yep, you know, going down, and it's all on that.
And it wouldn't even matter. Let's say that if I doubled this up and grabbed it end to end, that does have somewhat of a fixed resistance, although it doesn't, because again, the more I stretch it, the harder it gets. So I can make this one single band easier or harder depending on how long I make it. So for example, foot position, if I were to anchor this with both feet, and if I were to go very narrow with my feet, I have less resistance here than if I were to stretch the band out with a wider foot position and do the same thing.
This seems like you need to have that muscle-mind connection to
100%. I could do the same thing with a single instead of grabbing it on the end here and grab it just like this, and I can do curls. So I've got a lot of options. When we talk about progressive resistance, same thing. I mean, you want to talk about hard? Try doubling up two of these greens and doing biceps curls. So anyone who thinks that bands are too easy, you know, they're picturing something, you know, like this, like, you know, my 60-year-old, you know, aunt would do. If you were to ask me if I only use bands for the rest of my life and never trained with weights again, could I maintain the same physique I have now? And I'd say, yeah. You know, could I be a professional bodybuilder? You know,
you don't want to say no.
I don't know. There's part of me that wants to say no and part of me that wants to say yes. No one's ever tried it before.
Right. It'd
be a pretty interesting experiment.
Yeah.
I'll tell you this. How about this? When I use bands, I feel it more than when I feel it with free weights. I feel a better burn. I feel a better contraction. I feel more sore the next day.
Is that because you don't use them as much? Maybe just like you do with weights, your body will kind of adjust to it? Or is it like we're talking about the resistance in multiple directions, the variable resistance?
I think one, it's the variable resistance. Two, it promotes better form, so you can't cheat. So you're getting a peak contraction all the way through the range of motion. Like we're talking about at the top of the range of motion, you're still getting, you know, that peak contraction. So I think it just promotes better mind-muscle connection, better discipline, better form.